ई केमिस्ट्री क्लास फातिमा कॉन्वेंट हाई स्कूल माई सेल्फ दीपाली चैप्टर 5 पीरियोडिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स क्लास 10। इन दिस सेकेंड सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट डिड साइंटिस्ट एंड केमिस्ट मेंडेलिव टेल अस अबाउट द पीरियोडिक टेबल। मेकिंग ऑर्डर आउट ऑफ chaos, मेंडेलिव्स पीरियोडिक टेबल। Even after the rejection of Newland's law of octave, many scientists continued to search for a pattern that correlated the properties of elements with their atomic masses. The main credit for classifying elements goes to Marat Ivanovich Mendeleev, a Russian chemist. He was the most important contributor to the early development of periodic table of elements, wherein the elements were arranged on the basis of their fundamental properties, the atomic mass, and also on the similarities of chemical properties. Mendeleev, Matri Ivanovichi Mendeleev, was born in Tobolsk in Western Siberia, Russia, on 8 February 1834. After his early education, Mendeleev could join a university only due to the efforts of his mother. Dedicating his investigation to his mother, he wrote, "She instructed with examples, corrected with love, and traveled with me to places, sending her last resource and strength. She knew that with the aid of science, without violence, with love but firmness, all superstitious untruth and errors can be removed. The arrangement of elements he proposed is called Mendeleev's periodic table. The periodic table proved to be the unifying principle in chemistry. It was the motivation for the discovery of some new elements." So this was the important task played by Mendeleev. When Mendeleev started his work, only 63 elements were discovered. This 63 elements examined the relationship between the atomic masses of the elements and their physical and chemical properties. Among the chemical properties, Mendeleev concentrated on the compounds formed by the elements with hydrogen and oxygen. He selected hydrogen and oxygen as they are very reactive and formed compounds with most of the elements. So, he focused on the 63 elements, their atomic masses, and physical and chemical properties, which was not taken care of while classification by the previous scientists. He also checked the formula of hydrates and oxides formed by an element were treated as one of the basic properties of the elements for classification. So this was the basis of his classification, that is atomic masses, physical and chemical properties, the compounds formed by elements with oxygen and hydrogen that are hydrides and oxides. And he then took 63 cards and on each card he wrote down the properties of one element. He sorted out the elements in similar properties and pinned the cards together on the wall. He observed that most of the elements got a place in the periodic table and were arranged in order of their increasing atomic masses. It was also observed that there occurs a periodic recurrence of elements with similar physical and chemical property. So, this is why it is called as periodic recurrence. Periodic recurrence means a systematic step-by-step repetition of any property or any scenario is called as periodic recurrence. And on this basis, Mendeleev formulated the periodic law, which states that the property of elements are periodic functions of their atomic masses. Periodic functions means they keep on repeating with a constancy according to their atomic masses. So as the atomic masses increases, this property also increase but in a definite pattern. Mendeleev's periodic table contains vertical columns which are called as groups and horizontal rows which are called as periods, which is very similar to the modern periodic table. You can see the Mendeleev's periodic table as shown here. The group, that is group 1, which you can see this way, is the vertical column. Group 2, group 3, group 4, group 5, group 7 and group 8. So he had 8 groups. Similarly, he had made 6 periods starting from 1 to 6. These are the 6 periods which are the horizontal rows. Now if you try to observe, then in the first group and first period he placed hydrogen. Then second group and first period is lithium. Second group, second period is beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine as we go further according to their atomic masses are increasing. Then in third period and first group you have sodium, then magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. Like that way potassium, calcium, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc, gallium, germanium, arsenic, antimony and so on. So like that way Mendeleev's periodic table was published in the German journal in 1872. In the formula for oxides and hydrides at the top of the column, the letter R is used to represent any of the elements in the group, which can be observed here. So if you see in group 1, it forms R2O as oxides, RO as oxides, R2O3, RO2, R2O5, RO3, R2O7 and RO4. Same way the hydrides are RH, RH2, RH3, RH4, RH3, RH2 and RH. So you can observe how the properties of hydrides and oxides are represented. For example, hydrides of carbon is CH4 is written as RH4 and oxides of carbon is written as CO2 as RO2. Now what were the achievements of Mendeleev's periodic table? After observing this periodic table, you can see that while developing the periodic table, there were a few instances where Mendeleev had to place an element with a slightly greater atomic number before an element with a slightly lower atomic mass. The sequence was inverted so that the elements with similar properties could be grouped together. For example, cobalt atomic mass 58.9 appears before nickel mass 58.7. Look at the table. You will find out one more such analomy. Analomy means when you have the atomic mass greater and atomic number smaller. Further, Mendeleev left some gap in the periodic table. Instead of looking upon the gap as defect, Mendeleev boldly predicted that the existence of some elements that has not been discovered at that time, Mendeleev named them by suffix of Sanskrit numeral ika 1 to a name of preceding elements in the same group. For instance, scandium, gallium, germanium discovered later have the property similar to ica boron, ica aluminium and ica silicon, means prior to respectively. So you can see in the periodic table scandium is before boron, gallium is before aluminium and germanium is before silicon. The properties of ICA aluminum predicted by Mendeleev are those of elements of gallium, which were properties discovered later and replaced ICA aluminum in the list as follows. So you can see the properties of ICA aluminum and gallium. The atomic mass is 68 and 69.7. Then 62 E2O3 is Ga2O3 and ECl3 is GaCl3. This provided convincing evidences that both the correctness and usefulness of Mendeleev's periodic table. Further, it was the extraordinary success of Mendeleev's prediction that led chemists not only to accept his periodic table but also recognize him as an originator of the concept on which it is based. Noble gases like helium, HE, neon and argon have been mentioned in many a context before this. These gases were discovered very late because they were very inert and present in extremely low concentration in our atmosphere. So one of the strengths of Mendeleev's periodic table was that these gases were discovered. They could be placed in a new group without disturbing the existing order. So you can see the advantages of the Mendeleev's periodic table, which had given lots of predictions in spite of not being discovered. The elements were having exactly the same property as predicted by Mendeleev. The second important thing was they were having even the correctness and usefulness according to the chemist. The newly found elements had been given the place without disturbing or causing any problem to the prior any of the elements given in the table. Now, there were few limitations of these Mendeleev's periodic table still. So, we'll discuss that. Electronic configuration of hydrogen resembles that of alkali metal. Like alkali metals, hydrogen combines with halogen, oxygen and sulfur to form compounds having similar formula as shown in the figure. The examples here are HCl, NaCl, H2O, Na2O, H2S and Na2S. On the other hand, just like hydrogen, halogens, hydrogen also exists as diatomic molecules and it combines with metals and non-metals to form covalent bond. So hydrogen was not fitting the criteria of Mendeleev's periodic table, yet it was given a special position. Looking at its resemblance to alkali metal and halogen family, try to assign hydrogen a correct position in Mendeleev's table. To which group and period should hydrogen be assigned? Certainly, no fixed position can be given to hydrogen in periodic table. This was the first limitation of Mendeleev's periodic table. So, hydrogen made the Mendeleev's periodic table limited. He could not assign a correct position to hydrogen in his table. Second limitation is, isotopes were discovered longer after Mendeleev had proposed his periodic classification element. Let us recall the isotopes of elements having similar chemical properties but different atomic masses. Consider the isotopes of chlorine Cl35 and Cl37. Would you place them in different slots because their atomic masses are different? Or would you place them in the same position because their chemical properties are same? Thus, isotopes of all elements pose a challenge to Mendeleev's periodic table. Another problem was that atomic masses do not increase in a regular manner in going from one element to another. So, it was not possible to predict how many elements would be discovered between the two elements, especially when we consider the heavier elements. So these were the limitations which were faced by Mendeleev's periodic table. And these limitations overcome by the modern periodic table, and we get the final classification of elements in the form of modern periodic table, which is very much similar to the periodic table given by Mendeleev. So if you try to observe here, except for few variations, most of the things in the modern periodic tables are similar to the Mendeleev's periodic table. In next session, we will be studying about modern periodic table. Thank you.